This and a multiplication of it throughout the country is obviously a threat to the National Health Service, and if it goes on unchallenged, and we have to challenge it on behalf of the public, not just on behalf of the people who work there, if it goes on unchallenged, then of course it's going to change the whole nature of the NHS.
And what form is your challenge going to take?
We've had our conference last week. We showed great determination last week at our conference that we're going to resist this sort of development, this sort of privatisation development as well. And we are determined that we are going to defend the NHS.
The number of patients in these hospitals is less than half than it used to be. Doesn't it make sense to sell some of them off?
No, it doesn't. What we need to do is to make sure that the half that's left gets proper treatment and care. When we have done that, then we can see what needs to be done with the land.
The sell-off plan is part of a larger scheme to shift mental health care out of hospitals and into the home. But is it also part of a Tory plot to dismantle the NHS?
No. It's simply that we've got hospitals which were built 100 years ago for a mode of treatment which has long been out of date.
Isn't it just forcing the majority of them, forcing them back on the family and making the family take over from the NHS?
Certainly some of them will stay at home, but most of them will be treated successfully and will get better without the intervention of a large emporium somewhere in the wilds of darkest Surrey.